Welcome back. A year ago, Madhu Singh worked in a computer shop and Suleman Mirza was training to be a lawyer. Then this happened.
Fantastic, wasn't it? Well, they amazed millions of us, but they were just pipped to the post by George Sampson, very talented young lad, but they did come second.
So just how much has Britain's Got Talent changed their lives and what exactly can this year's entries expect? Well, welcome to Madhu Singh and Suleman Mirza. Welcome, gentlemen. Great to see you. So what's lovely about programmes like Britain's Got Talent is that you do get to see the moment someone's life changes. And at that moment, your life changed. Because you were planning to go back to your jobs, weren't you?
Well,
we didn't know. I mean, we literally thought, as soon as the competition finishes, we're back to our jobs. And it was a nice experience.
And you were at PC World?
PC World and
PC
Terminal
World
5.
And Terminal 5. And
you was a trainee lawyer. I took some leave, thinking naively that I'm going to go back to working with my clients, going back to the office again. And then that final happened, as you know. And then after that, it just hasn't stopped. Since even now.
And did that happen straight away? Literally, as you finished, you know, finished the show, the next few days, things started
literally,
changing?
Honestly, we finished on a Saturday, was the final, and then Sunday we had all these phone calls, which I just didn't know what was happening then, and on Monday we had to prepare for the tour. So it was non-stop, completely non-stop.
What's great about this success happening so fast? I mean, it's fantastic that it happened to you guys. I mean, it must be a hell of a shock because you have no idea that it's going to happen and you're not prepared for it. You got an email from YouTube saying, congratulations on this particular, that one specific day, your clip was the most watched in the world.
In the world. It was the audition clip, wasn't it? That's it was right. The audition clip, and it was about 7 or 10 days afterwards, after it was shown on TV, and then we got a message, and I thought it was a fake, but apparently that clip was shown. It was the most viewed clip, it was most hits on that one particular day in the whole entire world.
In the world, how amazing.
And it wasn't promoted or anything, so for that reason it's even more of an achievement. It was really great.
And you have been travelling all over the world, haven't you, in the last year? And you were you part of the opening of that huge hotel in Dubai with Kylie? That was a big night for you, wasn't
amazing,
it?
Amazing night. It was just, again, just being on that stage, being involved in all that, it was an experience and a half.
Yeah.
You'd never forget it.
But when that's happening, do you have to kind of pinch yourself? You're looking out at the audience going, you know, I used to work in PC World, I don't know what's happening.
I think the thing with us guys, we go into our little zones, he won't stop talking.
And you
can't get a word out of me.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, and it's just go there, concentrate, and then just live it up.
And who were people coming up to you afterwards? I mean, famous people are coming up afterwards and saying, oh, we love what you do, we're loving what you do.
Yeah, I remember, because we had Michael Douglas and Catherine Zeta-Jones that came up to us afterwards. They'd never seen the show in Britain, but they saw what we did on stage, and they were like, that's amazing, you know, you guys are fantastic. When are you coming over to America? And we said, we don't know quite yet, but, you know, we will one day, hopefully. So it was, I mean, when you get a response like that, because you do it so naturally, don't you? We just don't think about what we're doing, but then when you get a response, you think, well, okay, there's something here then.
Yeah. And you've got to meet Michael Jackson?
I got to meet Michael Jackson.
You've been trying to meet Michael Jackson for years.
I have indeed, since I was about this tall. I mean, it was a dream come true, really.
Yeah.
Britain's Got Talent was excellent. Doing the final was excellent. For me, on a personal basis, meeting Michael, it was for his press conference when he came here to announce the London shows that he's doing.
So will you get to be the warm-up for Michael Jackson?
Can we say anything?
Is it time to go now?
Could it happen?
It's very possible. All I can say is just watch this space.
Okay.
And anything would happen. I think announcements are made in May sometime.
Yeah, so
well, we wish you luck with that. How amazing.
Thank you so
what
much.
A dream come true that would be.
Absolutely.
And what else is going to happen for you guys now? What else can we look for?
Yeah, we're going to be going to Mumbai this year for India's Got Talent.
What fun.
Yeah.
That's going to be amazing fun, especially because obviously the motherland. but We've had so many messages and support from people from India. The YouTube clip, as you mentioned, has gone and spread everywhere in the whole of India, Pakistan. Even when we went to Dubai as well, we were getting stopped every 2 minutes, like, excuse me.
It's really weird. That's a really weird situation.
That was quite scary for us, because we were like, hold on, we're in Dubai.
What advice do you have? Because the new series, Britain's Got Talent, starts on Saturday at 7:45 on ITV1. We've been waiting for it for such a long time, and now it's back. What advice do you give to the people, not the nutters at the beginning,
but the ones
later on, who look like it may happen for them?
Oh, wow. Do you know, because what it is, obviously it's all been recorded beforehand. They've done their auditions now, and they know, I mean, now they're all getting ready for their live shows that are coming up. Probably next month they'll be shown. So it's almost a calm before the storm for them. They know that something's about to happen. They're all sitting down waiting for the show on Saturday, so it's a really exciting time for them. Yeah. All I can say is, listen, just be confident, believe in what you're doing, completely have faith in what you're doing, because if you don't believe in it, you can't sell it. Mm. So have faith in what you're doing, and try to make it just different. You need to be a bit unique. Mm. And I'm sure you'll go far. The audience at home will love you. But it's a great time for them, you know. They should really enjoy the experience.
Well, you two were certainly unique. We hadn't seen anything like it. You were fantastic. And I'm so pleased for your success. Long may it continue.
Thank you.
And do let us know if you hear from Michael Jackson. We would like to be the first to know.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Would you promise?
Front row tickets.
Hold on a second.
it's a contract. Front row tickets
at the O2. Yeah. Michael Jackson. Yeah. Can you sign that for me, please? Thank you very much.
I should be a training lawyer. That's dangerous.
He's done it! Hey! He's signed it. Thanks, guys. Thank you very much indeed.
Right,
save that piece of paper. How would